What I thought I'd do with the short time, and given that 2 weeks ago we had our full year results presentation and met with many of our investors, I thought I'd move through pretty quickly and leave some good time at the end for questions around the key issues. Moving to the next slide and to the agenda slide, actually, two slides on. The way I thought I'd approach it is to run through the key highlights, then quickly move through the financial performance. Very, very strong performance this year. This is the final year of our second eight-point plan. Touch on the AIRR acquisition, which was the wholesale business that we acquired last year, and then move into the third eight-point plan that runs from this financial year through to FY 2023 and the market outlook. Moving to the next slide. I think in understanding Elders and what we've done with the first two eight-point plans, it's very important to understand the business model. We run the business on a return on capital basis, with the whole portfolio being able to manage the generally present agricultural risk so that we can actually have smooth growth at a high return on capital. When we look at how we do that, we do it through having multiple diversifications in the business model. You can see on the slide on the screen, we have diversifications through our rural products, through our agency services, with multiple areas, sheep, cattle, wool, grain, through our real estate services, metropolitan franchise, broadacre property management, our financial services with lending for working capital loans, and also larger acquisition loans, our insurance business, delivery guarantee product for livestock and for wool, and then through our digital and technical services, where it's basically advice and online services, and then through to our feed and processing businesses, which is our feedlot activity and also our China farm food business. We have multiple diversifications through product and service. In rural products, we also have channel diversification with retail and wholesale channels. We have geographical diversification throughout Australia and a very small business in China. We have crop segment diversifications through whether it's irrigated cotton or summer crops through to winter crops through horticulture, sugarcane, dairy, etc. That's how we drive our strong growth through the cycles, even though we're an agricultural business. For the last 6 years, the first two eight-point plans, you've seen that constant growth at very high return on capital. Our target was 20%, which we have been exceeding return on capital, and through drought occurrences, flood occurrences, bushfire occurrences, COVID occurrences. When you look at Elders, people see, you know, 181-year-old agricultural business or agribusiness in Australia and may see the fluctuations in earnings, etc., based on that. The Elders business model allows us to grow consistently at high returns through the agricultural cycles. Moving to the next slide and just to recap on the first two eight-point plans. The history here is reasonably important because Elders got into significant financial problems in the 2007, 2008. I'd actually come onto the Elders board as a non-exec director in the end of 2009, 2010. Previously, I've been CEO of six other agricultural companies, including Landmark, the major competitor, and Wesfarmers CSBP, supply companies, production companies, and distribution companies. I became chairman and executive chairman in 2013, and then set about developing the first eight-point plan. We'd just announced a half a billion dollar loss, put in place the first eight-point plan, and searched for a new CEO, and the board asked me if I'd take on the CEO role, which I agreed to do to kind of shepherd the business back into profitability. At the end of the first eight-point plan, we'd overachieved, as you can see on the right-hand slide, Financial measures and the return on capital measures, with an average return on capital through that period of 26.3%. Critically, and I found this in every business I've run, going hand in hand with a very strong safety culture. So prior to that, there were 34 lost time injuries, and we've come to the point today of having two lost time injuries. So I've seen a direct alignment of a strong safety culture, a strong behavioural culture, a values-based culture, and strong financial performance. We look at the second eight-point plan, and you can see through the second eight-point plan, again, we consulted our investors and said, you know, what would be an acceptable approach to the second eight-point plan in terms of financial metrics. We agreed a 5 to 10% growth in EBIT through the agricultural cycles at 20% return on capital would be something that our investors were happy with. And we've just announced the results for those for the end of the second eight-point plan, three-year parent plan, where we hit just 119 million EBIT, which was significantly higher than the than the 5 to 10% growth, very strong return on capital, and basically delivered all the or over-delivered all of those objectives. So if we look at the next slide, just to quickly look at the highlights from this year, the results that were announced. As I mentioned, two lost time injuries and a reduction in our lost time injury frequency. The continued emphasis on safety, health, the environment. We were early, we took an early lead on our COVID, establishing our COVID committee, given that we have a business in China shortly after Chinese New Year, where many of the big cities in China were being shut down. We put in place the committee in Australia, and we were very well positioned then to do our work with our colleagues on agriculture being an essential industry, and also ensuring that we had no contact deliveries and all of the social distancing and all the protocols in place prior. And of course, the joke in agriculture is that when you sign up to be a farmer, you sign up for social distancing and no contact. So, but this coincided with a break in the 100-year drought that occurred on the East Coast. And so we were very, very well positioned to take advantage of that. You see from a financial performance for the last 12 months, 62% growth in underlying EBIT, a significant improvement in cash operating cash flow, return on capital at 20.2%, taking the AIRR acquisition out, and over the 8-point plan period of 20.3%. When we bought AIRR and raised capital, we and used some debt, we said we get our leverage back to our acceptable 1.5 to 2 over a 2-year period. We got back to 1.6 in the first year, and earnings per share increased of 35%. The other big issues in closing out the second 8-point plan have been around the integration of AIRR, overachieving where we thought we'd be in terms of synergies. Our mantra is that we do acquisitions with EPS accretion pre-synergies, and so synergies are the cream on top. And so our backward integration strategies with Titan have been very, very solid, and we've also announced our third eight-point plan. So moving to the next slide, I won't dwell on too many of the first two items, but in key relationships, very strong growth with if we look at the fourth point on key relationships, we've gone from 4% of women in management positions at the start of the first eight-point plan to 15% now, and our target of 25% over the next eight-point plan. We've also developed our significant linkages with all the research organisations, the rural research organisations, with our Thomas Elder Consulting and Thomas Elder Institute. And if we look at the other great initiatives, we launched our sustainability report this year. We put that team in place October last year, and have with the view that we would firstly identify all the wonderful work done through elders in the regional rural communities that we live in, but also in having done that, then set our very strong targets for the next eight-point plan. So So moving to the next slide and the results in a different layer, but you can see very, very strong growth from the first 8-point plan across multiple metrics overachieving the targets that we'd set. So quickly moving to the next couple of slides, just to demonstrate the diversification point, and you can see by product the strong growth across multiple products as we deliver the result. Next slide across geographies in a very similar way. In terms of our the next slide at our capital management, our ROS return on capital philosophy and very, very high financial discipline goes hand in hand with our diversification strategy, and is the reason that over the last 6 years we've delivered to the very, very high level that we've delivered, and you've seen the very strong growth in share price and our market cap. So on the next slide, our cash generation, we thought we'd be very, very clear on how a strong, very strong cash generation works, and we like to fully disclose and explain all aspects of the business as we run it. But just looking at the AIRR acquisition, just to touch on that, because we have over-delivered in the next one more slide on the AIRR acquisition. But we have we believed that we would deliver midpoint of our synergies for the first year. We had the business for 10 months, so we thought we'd be on track to deliver around $3 million of those synergies, and we've over-delivered there at $5 million. But the integration has gone very, very well, and the business is operating very strongly and kept up its momentum. So quickly then to focus on the third 8-point plan in the next slide. And you can see the third 8-point plan, our ambition. Again, we did a survey of 40 or 50 of our investors to get their view on what they were after. The 5-10% EBIT and earnings per share growth is what we're targeting at a 15% return on capital. With the acquisition of AIRR, this has brought our capital down, but our return on capital target down. We're still operating at the 18% plus, but we wanted to ensure, in fact, our shareholders wanted to ensure that we didn't lose any opportunities by having too high a target, given that our weighted average cost of capital is around that 8%. Sustainability work we're doing is critical, and being the most trusted brand is also critical. So Roy Morgan did a research this year that showed that Elders is the unprompted most trusted brand in agriculture and regional rural Australia, and we really want to hang on to that as we come into our 182nd year next year. So when we look at the strategic priorities, winning market share, capturing by filling our holes around Australia, so slip back a slide, winning market share as a strategic priority, capturing more gross margin through our backward integration strategy, offering more products in our agency and livestock area, optimising our feed and processing business as we have been doing with our feedlot, and driving our sustainability agenda. Big issue for us in the next 3 years is our systems modernisation, which we've started to work through, which will offer the platform for our growing online and digital activity. Retaining the best people and an inclusive work environment, and then continuing very, very high discipline. So with that, I might pull up at that point, and we can go to questions.